Here we go, the first of our double main event here at Night of Infamy. The champion, Jon Moxley, taking on the newly christened Golden Boy, Drake Younger, for the world title.
Here we have it, the greatest and longest reigning CZW world champion in history, the Golden Boy, Drake Younger, taking on the man, Jon Moxley, who has had a stranglehold on that title for the last 9 months.
This is going to be interesting, to say the least. Drake Younger with a change of heart over in Oberhausen, in Germany, of course, back here at the arena, attacking his best friend, Scotty Vortex.
Hey, he left that man behind because right now there's only one thing he wants. Whoa! And that one thing he wants, whoa, is what Jon Moxley has.
Drake Younger looks like he's been beaten with a bottle of peroxide.
Hey, the Golden Boy's hair matches the Golden Boy's smell. The smell of gold comes off Drake Younger. Go get a whiff of him, Greg. You'll love it.
I'm not smelling anything.
Quick cover now. Apparently the Golden Boy no longer wrestles in ring gear either.
Look at how well he's dressed. Look at those pants. They gotta go for $200, but his chest right now is flaring up thanks to Moxley.
Moxley gonna end this quickly with a Fujiwara armbar. Drake Younger, maybe a Golden Boy, he can't take away anything of his wrestling credential. A former CZW World Heavyweight Champion, held that belt for well over a year, defeated Nick Gage at Tangled Web 1 to be crowned.
And the greatest champion of all time, Drake Younger. Oh, gets caught with a dropkick, but look what he's wrestling with. His arm's all taped up because of what happened to him over in Germany in a match with Masada. That's how bad he wants the title. He's willing to wrestle injured.
Moxley with a head of steam there.
Ahead.
Pardon me, Mr. Excellent. Laying out the Golden Boy here. Irish whip counter. Mox up and over. And these guys have each other so well.
Whoa! Look at this. Look at Drake Younger. He knows what to do. He knows how to pull a weapon out when it's necessary.
Is that a four?
Hey, the Golden Boy will use silverware to dine on his opponents.
Interestingly enough, that's usually the weapon of choice of one Jon Moxley.
Well, then Moxley has it coming. This is karma for all the things he's done with that fork.
Jon Moxley coming off of a Germany tour, also defended the CZW World Heavyweight Championship against one Devin Moore in a phenomenal contest. He had a chance to get that on DVD from czwrestling.com.
And while we thank you for joining us for this DVD, please join us. Oh, God.
This is vicious. Thanksgiving came early. Yeah, I was going to say, you stole the word, bro.
And what a great Thanksgiving it's going to be for the Younger family as he sits at the Thanksgiving table with his family with the gold around his waist.
At Thanksgiving dinner, really?
I would.
You would. And what else would happen when Drake Younger wins the title is this crowd will erupt in pure golden joy, just like when he won the title the first time.
Somehow I think you missed the reaction they had to him earlier when he gave his initial address at the top of the hour.
Hey, this crowd will turn on you in a second, huh, Greg?
Let's not talk about that. Let's talk about the actions going on. Jon Moxley bleeding like a stuck pig, wearing the crimson mask here.
Oh, look at Drake just pounding away, digging into the flesh, cutting open the world champion.
It's not technical, but it is effective.
Drake Younger's second shot since he lost the title on January 30th to B-Boy. But this is the first singles match he's had for that title. And listen to these people. They just love to see Drake Younger staring at him in awe.
I'm not really sure if that's all. I think it's more like disgust and bewilderment. I mean, that's what I would put on it.
Whoa!
Nice cross body. Raining down the right hand.
Hit the cross body. He got right above his
fighting him. Payback for all those fork shots.
Greg, if you were in a situation like this, you're going to be able to come back and be stabbed with a fork. Oh! What would you do? I was about to ask. I'd avoid the fork, but...
A anything and everything. Jon Moxley is a ring veteran. He knows exactly what he's getting himself into. And you scrape, you scratch, you poke, you do whatever you have to do to maintain being the CZW World Heavyweight Champion.
It's a situation Drake Younger is more familiar with than anyone else in the history of this company. It is why he's the greatest champion. And it's moves like that, grounding a man, stretching him out, is why Drake Younger was the most successful champion we've ever had.
Call me old-fashioned. I miss the old Drake Younger that came out and, you know, fought for these fans, fought for his pride. Now he's signed a lucrative deal. He's a sellout, man.
Four figures, buddy. I can sell out for four figures.
That's like $12,000 a year. He's gonna get taxed now. He's gonna get 1099. You gotta think about it that way.
He's gonna be eating good, and he's gonna be able to eat if he wants to use the world title as a plate. So when he's finished his meal, he can just look at it all the time.
It's just plain disrespectful. I'm sorry.
Chop.
You know, the interesting about Moxley, though, is I believe last month you actually said he was a dominant champion. That's actually not the case. It's that Moxley has been a successful champion because he always finds a way to win. He's a clutch player.
Oh, the Hulk Hogan of CZW.
No! That move always works in world title matches.
Didn't work in this one. Moxley had jammed his knee there.
Jammed his knee up, and Drake Younger knows exactly what to do. He knows to attack the knee. He's like a pit bull in that ring. He's latching onto the leg, and he's twisting it out of the socket.
Oh, are you kidding me? Those are street shoes. Actually, I think they're turn shoes.
I don't think I can say this in this building, can I?
You can say anything you want, but yes. And it wasn't over a Sprite this time or a 7-Up. But what's going to happen here is Drake Younger's going to go up, and Mox is going to go down, and now the belt of Drake Younger comes off so he can replace it with a shinier, bigger, prettier belt by the end of this battle.
And look at this now, Younger just trying to choke the life out of the champion.
Well, is life worth living if you're not a world champion? Maybe not for Jon Moxley.
Oh, God, he's hanging the man. Look at this.
Hey, he has still five.
Trying to work his hand in between the belt and his throat. Look at him, he is fading.
He's fading quick. He's fading quick, but the glory of Drake Younger is going up even quicker. Drake Younger releases it, because Drake Younger has something even more diabolical planned.
That's all well and good, but you know, Mox had passed out in that situation. Drake Younger would then have to try and get the limp body of Jon Moxley back into the ring to win the world title.
That's a great point, but the point is, it takes a long time to recover from being choked out with a belt. If Drake moves quick, he would have been able to do it, but he's got other plans.
There's a time when this crowd would have erupted in applause every time Drake Younger picked up the chair.
And now they're sitting there angrily, upset that they know what's going to happen, that Drake Younger is going to win the title. He's going to be able to have a big party with all the women he wants later on tonight when he walks around town with that gold.
Oh, and look at this. Mox running back from the knees. Oh! And there is that implant DDT.
That's exactly what Moxley needed right now. High impact move to take down the Golden Boy.
Mox now back to his feet. This crowd firmly behind him.
Mox just lost a lot of blood. Let's see what he's got left in the tag here.
I don't know. He's on the move. Big back elbow.
And Jon Moxley has got to go for a cover. But like you said, he's lost so much blood, and that might have been all he had left in the tank. That might be all he has left.
I don't know. We've seen Moxley time and time again with his back against the wall. And he always seems to have a little more than you give him credit for.
Hey, I've always called him the craftiest world champion in history, but he's dealing with the greatest world champion.
And right now, he's lighting up the greatest world. Oh! Younger saw what was coming, clotheslined him to the outside, and this is not where Mox wants to be.
It's not where he wants to be, but it's where Drake Younger has him, and Drake Younger is going to upgrade from the fourth.
You never know what's underneath a CZW ring.
You've got it.
Younger now going for the table.
And this this is going to be the finale. This is how he's going to finish off Moxley. If he can use that table, do what he has to do, we're going to have a new world champion. Oh!
The end of the table, no less, driven into the champion's rib.
And that's going to affect Moxley if he even has the opportunity to latch on a hook and ladder later. When your ribs are sore, it's hard to execute anything, let alone breathe.
Drake Younger probably looking to hit that Drake's landing, his finish. The move that has won so many matches here in CZW.
Oh, he's setting him up. Your lips to his ears.
All right, man. We all love Drake, but I wouldn't go that far. But how far is Drake going to go on that table? This Moxley's got a counter. But if he could get Drake back in the ring, he's going to retain the title. Drake's neck. He's dripping from the table straight to the floor.
And again, this gives Moxley the opportunity he needs to try and recover, to try and recuperate together.
And it's something John Moxley is so good at. He's so great in the clutch, like you said earlier. But he is dealing with Drake Younger, another proven clutch performer.
Mox actually said to me, you know, he might not score 30 points a game, but he finds a way to hit that 3-point right at the buzzer. That is what his specialty is.
The baseball analogy works, but Moxley is still down. But what's more important, what's in the ring right now, Drake Younger, John Moxley, world title on the line, they let it all hang out here at Dynamite 59.
What a co-main event, of course, you got fans bring the weapons.
Oh, Cutter!
He's got him hooked!
Oh, so close! So close that Papa George's hand actually hit the mat a split second after Drake Younger lifted his shoulder.
It doesn't get any closer than that, but look at Mox now. Mox, oh! Mox finally got his hands on the fork. Younger, though, with a low blow.
Younger with the perfect counter, a champion's counter.
A low blow, really?
Hey, whatever works in a situation like this. Are you trying to use it at tables? Oh, there we go. The annihilation. You just want to spray it all over him and soak him in it.
Jesus. I can't sit next to you anymore.
Oh!
Good God! Sits out with the Blue Thunder. This could do it right here. Oh!
Almost had a new world champion. And Drake Younger has a right to be angry. Drake Younger now perfecting his balance by putting his shoe back on and perfecting the dent in the skull of John Moxley.
The champ is out cold. But Younger taking this opportunity to jaw jack, to try and piss off these fans even further instead of making a cover. If you really want to be the world champion, pin the man, for Christ's sake.
Oh, he will. Give him a minute here. But you don't want to give Moxley a minute. This might actually be a bad idea by the Golden Boy. Here it comes.
He's going for it. He's got him up.
Drake's landing. New champion.
He's got him covered. This is it.
No.
Younger now going to the chairs. Oh, look at this.
Look at that demonic structure. His two steel folding chairs, ass to ass, upside down, all around. That's just going to hurt.
And you get dropped on those mating steel chairs, this match is over. Oh, look at Moxley. Oh, he's got him rolled up. He got him.